All right, I'm going to show you how to install the monorail mod. Very easy. First thing we're going to do is take off this screw right here by Scratchy on that post holding this wire form. And there's one more screw right here at the sling. I put a towel down so my screws and washers won't drop into the itchy and scratchy saucer or behind the drops. And I'm going to pause the video real quick so I can take those screws off. All right, I pulled the wire form off. This piece here may drop while you're doing that. I just pushed it back onto the support on the other side there by the couch to show you to keep it on. But you could pull it off at the same time you're pulling off the wire form. It just slides out. There is, if we can see here, there's a little three-fingered thing above the lamp right there, the black bracket. It slides there with that middle finger right in the V and the other two on the outside. So it just slides out of there. And now you have your V-track in your hand for the monorail. All right, I'm going to pause again so I can grab the monorail mod. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is identify that the decal side of the V-track is what you will see as a player. Okay, and the mod, the nose car is going to have the monorail decal on it and a red stripe on the nose. Okay, so this is going to slip on the opposite side of that V-track, not this side, because of that little thing there. I think it can get in, but it's just easier on this other side. So, sorry about the video. See, you're just going to put it in there. It's not connected. Okay, see how it's wobbling around. I'm going to turn it around to the other side, to the back side. Make sure the monorail sticker is facing out towards the player. And what I want to do here, it's easier with two hands, is rest that V track, that one gray lip on the opposite side. The other side's not attached yet. I'm going to set my phone down and snap it in with my thumbs on this gray base. Okay, I'm going to put a thumb over there underneath the one screw on the gray and a thumb underneath the other screw on the gray. Maybe I can set my phone here. There, look at that. All right. So it's resting on the opposite side. And I'm going to use both thumbs, and my four fingers are on the inside of the V-track, and I'm going to snap it. Hear it snap? Okay, now it's on. Both sides are on, and this thing can slide back and forth. Okay, so we're going to push it a little bit forward, not all the way. Okay, and that's the first car is on. We're going to put the middle car on now. All right, you want to identify the part that is facing the player is going to have the door with the little gray window. The other side does not have that. Okay. So that little gray window and the door is going to be on the same side as that monorail sticker. So I'm going to flip it around because I'm coming from the backside. And I'm just going to feed that through. And I need enough room here to get my hands and resting it on that other side. And got to get it resting on that other side first. All right, rested on that other side. I got my thumbs in there, and it just snapped right in. Okay, I can slide that back and forth. It's not going to come off. Okay, all right, and I just push it right up against the other monorail for now. And we got one more to do. The last car. Okay, the last car doesn't have a stripe on the nose, and It does have a door and a window, so that's the side that's going to face towards the player. The opposite side does not. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing. Give yourself some room between the middle car and this one so you can snap it in. Sorry, I was off video a little bit. Same procedure as the other two. I can slide it right up against. Okay, let me pick this up again. Now, this is not where it's going to be on the track. You're going to have to slide it probably forward in order to get it on. Okay, so let's see if I can do this one-handed. I'm going to put that right there with the outer edges above and that finger in the middle, but the two on the outside. Okay, now it's just resting here. It looks like I need to come forward a little. For the most part, we're going to butt it up against the wire form, and so we can move this probably up to the sticker, and I'll be pretty close. Okay, so I'm just going to gently hold it in place. Where can I put this? Probably making you all dizzy. Trying to find a spot in my game where I can set the phone down. All right, I'm just gonna slide that forward. Slide the middle car forward. Slide that last car forward. All right, now we're gonna put the wire form back on. Okay, so you got three prongs on the wire form. The two across the bottom go into the holes there, and they slide right in. And you're gonna put the screw back on the scratchy post, and then the other one on the sling. I'm gonna turn off the camera so I can do that. All right, I have the wire form back on. You want to make sure that you adjust it so your ball is going to fall without interfering with the bracket guide down there. And where I have the monorail right now, the V track wiggles back and forth. Okay, so I want to bring it all the way back towards the upper play field, and then I'm going to slide the cars closer to the edge of this right there until it hits, and that way it won't wiggle back and forth. Okay, I'm gonna set the phone down. Let's see if I can balance it here. Probably not. I'm gonna do it with my arm. All right, holding the V track and just sliding that forward, sliding that forward, sliding that forward. That showed up. And there you go. Test it with a ball. I'm gonna drop a ball off. We got clearance, drops down fine. All right. So a lot of people say that the monorail blocks your view of shots. I can still see the ramp. I can still see the right orbit. I can still see the auto shot. I can still see the garage. I can't see really Bart's Newton ball, but I only hit that by accident, so I don't really care about that. And it really doesn't block anything any more than the upper play field or Homer's head blocks the ball coming around the orbit to that right flipper. So, I don't know. You guys can decide. All right. Hope you have an easy install, and thank you for buying the monorail mod.